I basically just wanted to know how many people come up to you and tell you wire lines. Like it must happen like every day.
It happens at least once a day.
Really?
Yeah, unless I stay at home by myself, you know? And depending on which part of the city I go to, it can happen sometimes 3 or 4 times a day. I've resigned myself to the fact that that's just something I'm going to have to live with.
Okay.
But I can think of worse things in life, so.
I won't make you do any, so don't worry about
it. Won't make me do what?
Say any.
It never gets old.
Right. I wanted to kind of ask you about how you sort of transitioned from doing a role that was that kind of iconic and that dramatic to doing something funny and a comedy that like Cedar Rapids, like how that sort of like.
Well, you know, I thought what sort of made a character in The Wire popular was that he was funny.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, he was this, but that he did enjoy what he was doing in life, and so there was a fair amount of comedy with it. You know, I mean, you're not playing for that. You're just doing the wonderful scripts that they would write, but there was some humor there, you know, and fortunately, I was able to find the humor in that. As far as Cedar Rapids, it was a little easier to find the humor, but you still—it's going the other way. Now you've got to find the humanity of the character,
yeah,
with the comedy. So it's sort of working backwards in a way, but you're going to end up with the same result.
So it's a flip side of the same coin, basically.
Right.
Awesome.
Right.
Well, because you did get some of the best lines in the movie. Like you definitely have the biggest laugh. So that's something.
That's good. You know, I mean, you know, I never know. I never know what people are going to respond to. But I'm very happy they enjoy it.
Awesome. Cool. Thank you. Yeah.